inside the temple goes back up, they have bacteria that when you put on my father goes there and eats your food. And it turns it into kind of dirty brown water. And eventually it just soaks into the soil. And that's the main reason we don't drink the water. They do purify the water, so I don't want to drink that water, but you don't want to be drinking that kind of water, because it just goes into the ground. What doesn't go into the ground and what the myofauna, one of the microbes, can't eat is toilet paper. So you'll notice in every next to the bathroom that you go to, and in most of the world, the bathrooms all have a garbage can. And after you wipe, and you look and see, yeah, still brown, I gotta wipe it again, I would ask you to fold it so that when me or him or whoever has to clean the bathroom goes in there, we don't have to see what color your food is. Fold it and throw it in the trash can. And I'm going into all this because you don't have to do this in America. In fact, when I get back across the border, I'm going to go to Wendy's or McDonald's, wherever it's at, and I'm just going to flush that toilet paper. I'm just going to grab spots of it and flush it because we can. But down here, you cannot. When one of you drops something in the toilet because you're wiping up this guy's toilet. It's just going to happen. Some of you have already done it. I know it's not my first rodeo down here. There is a coat hanger. We call it a fishing rod. Please fish that out and take that wet, dirty thing and drop it in the Somebody, sooner or later, has to go into that septic tank and get all that out of it. People will fill the septic tank up. How about that job?
Anybody hungry?
If you have a sandwich, come get me. Make sure I'm right in the middle of taking a good bite. Come get me with that. Clean up after yourselves. When we leave here today,
amen.
I almost guarantee I'm going to have to pick up 10 coffee cups and go home. If you see something dirty, pick it up and do it. Take care of your own stuff upstairs. I guarantee if I had an inspection of the girls' dorm right now, it would look like an abortion. That's too strong.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It would look worse than that. It is probably a mess. So, clean up after yourself. Be respectful of the people around you. You're living on top of people for 4 days. And you don't take care of your stuff, and they don't take care of their stuff, and the place is just a mess, and real tough to clean up. You have no food upstairs? Whatever food you got upstairs, try to get it out of there and make sure it's sealed very tight, because the last thing you want is ants up in the dorms. You don't want that. I know somebody up there that's going to leave it up there, but don't let it be flopping all on the floor, because food attracts bugs, and you don't want bugs. It's taken us a long time to get it to look this clean. We used to have a lot of bugs here. Cups, I think we're good with that. We used to have to save our cup because we were going to get any cups.
If you have your water bottle, just use those water bottles. That saves us.
There are big gates out there. Those, do not go past those gates unless one of the big guys, an adult, is moving. You go up to the gate, Monday morning it's going to be crazy out there because they have all of the shops that open up. They come into town, they put up tents, they're selling veggies. And
Monday's actually going to be even more crazy because this Monday is actually a national holiday for the 1910 Revolutionary War.
Oh,
it's what?
Our Mexican Revolution. So everything's closed. It's going to be nuts.
There are two stores out there. One right across the street, one way on down the street. You can go to those in groups of five with an adult, but I would ask that you don't do it right before dinner. Because They have sweets over there, they got chips, they got sodas, you can go get drinks if you don't like what we're serving to drink, which is water. If you want a soda or something like that, then ask one of the adults that is not busy to walk you over there. Don't spend all your money doing it. But if you get a lot of food, don't eat it right before Elizabeth puts out a great spread for us. The cooking here is fantastic, and you will like it. So you can go to town and get that. If you're driving a vehicle, whoever has keys to the vehicles, they come to Richard every night and hang them on a key rack and they're in here somewhere. Because in the middle of the night, some of those vehicles got to move to let other people out.